Samsung engineers have been able to describe a way to copy and transfer the structure of the brain to a neuromorphic chip, which will allow the reproduction of unique computational characteristics. In this issue, I will tell you all the secrets of how Samsung plans to copy the human brain into semiconductor chips. As a result of the joint work of Samsung engineers and scientists from Harvard University, the technology of creating neuromorphic chips was born. The plan is to copy the brain's neural connectivity map using an array of nanoelectrodes, then paste it into a three-dimensional solid-state memory network. Neuromorphic engineering. What is it? Scientists have been studying neuromorphic engineering for a long time, since the 1980s in fact. But no one has been able to replicate the structures of the brain's neural connections on a silicon chip up until now. Therefore, the goal of the neuromorphic engineering was simplified to the creation of a chip inspired by the brain, rather than representing its exact imitation. The human brain includes a huge number of neurons where synaptic connections are responsible for performing brain functions. Understanding and in-depth studies of the circuitry of the neural connections is the key to reverse engineering the brain with reconstructed memory circuits. As a result, unique capabilities can be achieved, such as low energy consumption and adaptation to the environment, easy learning, and cognitive ability, all of which are not yet available with modern technology. What are neuromorphic chips? The difference between neuromorphic chips and conventional ones lies in the way information is processed, such as processors resembling the working of the human brain. They process data in much the same way as a human brain reacts to incoming information through communication between neurons. According to experts, neuromorphic processors are so far the most realistic way to create full-fledged artificial intelligence. The creation of a superprocessor built from transistors imitating the work of neurons is only theoretically possible so far. Neuromorphic engineering, which is devoted to the transfer and reproduction of analog calculations of the human brain in the form of a digital solution, is exploring this direction. Despite all the difficulties of recreating the workings of the human brain, there are already practical examples in this field. As I recall, in 2014, on behalf of DARPA, IBM created the True North Modular System. This is an artificial network built around multiple processors, housing 4.5 billion transistors with 256 million emulated synapses. Engineers managed to create an energy-efficient network to recreate as accurately as possible the way the brain works. True North consumed only 70 milliwatts, less than the 140 watts of power required to operate an Intel processor. Is it possible to copy a brain? A peculiarity of the human brain is the processing and transmission of information by means of chemical connections. If there are billions of neurons, then there are even more synaptic connections between them. That is why I think it is not yet possible to digitize human thinking into its pure form. Samsung engineers estimate that several trillion units of independent memory would be needed to make the copying happen. The essence of most modern systems is based on the concept developed in the middle of the XX century by mathematician John von Neumann. Its essence is the principle of the joint storage of commands and data in computer memory, addressability, and program management, but it has many imperfections. According to neural network specialists, in order to create a real neuromorphic system, we must move away from these principles and turn to neurobiology. Neuroengineering is currently facing the important task of creating a mechanism that could learn from the image of a living mind, which is impossible without studying the mystery of how the human brain works. The human brain is an almost perfect optimized system thanks to the revolution. So I think scientists still have a lot of work to do in this area before they can get to the bottom of it. The essence of the concept of copying the brain on a chip. Let me try to explain the concept. Actually, it's quite simple. The essence lies in two words: copy and paste. In their work, scientists propose a way to copy a map of neural connections to the brain using a revolutionary matrix of nanoelectrodes, which was just developed by scientists from Harvard, and paste this map into a high-density three-dimensional network of solid-state memory. The leadership in creating this technology belongs to Samsung. In the future, this discovery will make it possible to create a brain for artificial intelligence. But for now, the human mind is superior to even the most powerful computer, and the development of artificial intelligence is only at the beginning of its development. How can a copied brain change our lives? I, like I think many of you, feel uncomfortable with the idea that artificial intelligence will be able to replicate the structure of the human brain at the microprocessor level. So it turns out that the chips in smartphones and other devices will be smarter and more intelligent than humans? But I'm sure that the machine will not be able to copy the flexibility of the mind, the creativity of the human being. But it is already clear that the boundaries between human brains will be almost erased.